So, one thing gamers usually do when they need some extra power for a game is to overclock their graphic cards. Overclocking is the action of increasing a component's clock rate, running it at a higher speed than it was designed to run. Now, you probably knew this. This is common practice on dedicated GPUs, but that is not what we'll be using today. IntelHD, the integrated GPU packed inside a modern Intel CPU. They're usually considered virtually useless for gaming, although if you have been following this channel for some time, you know this is definitely not what I think, and they're often less flexible to tweak. But can this ultimate low budget GPU be overclocked? Turns out in some cases, you can. While hunting around for a cheap used motherboard for another video, I came around this, the Asus H81MK. This motherboard lists Asus GPU Boost as a feature with a little image showing a voltage and frequency control for an integrated GPU. And this is where I got really curious. I decided to combine this motherboard with an Intel Celeron G1840 with an Intel HD, mainly because it was quite literally the cheapest CPU I could find for this socket. You may recognize this as the CPU and GPU I used for the Mirror's Edge Catalyst video. But before we begin, let's make a disclaimer. Overclocking can be dangerous to your components. You are, after all, pushing components beyond what they were designed for. If you're going to try any of this, know what you're doing, know the thermal limits of your CPU, do your research, and keep an eye on your temperature. Alright, before getting started with overclocking, I decided to benchmark some GPU bottleneck games. The Just Cause 2 Dark Tower benchmark on 720p, all settings to the lowest, made an average of 28 FPS. Bioshock Infinite's benchmark on all the lowest settings and 720 did an average of 31 FPS, which is way more than I expected. A short Skyrim Special Edition test on 960x540 on all the lowest settings gave me an average of 21 FPS. And finally, because I really wanted to push this thing to the limit, the GTA 5 benchmark on 800x600 and all the lowest settings pulled around 28 FPS. Although, be warned, the game was running into a lot of micro stutter, the flying and driving portions, so reaching an average was really hard. Okay, we got our numbers. Now let's reboot and take a look into the BIOS of the motherboard. As you can see, in the advanced section there's a value that allows me to change the frequency multiplier of the integrated GPU. And you can see how it causes the max frequency on the Intel HD to rise from its usual maximum of 1200 MHz. The first thing I did was to increase it all the way to 1500. The same Just Cause 2 benchmark climbed from 28 to 36 FPS in average. Bioshock Infinite saw a sharp increase as well, all the way from 31 FPS to 39 FPS. Skyrim Special Edition went from 21 to 34, this might be the most dramatic increase I saw. And GTA 5 climbed from 28 to 36, an equally impressive change, but the micro stutter was still there. As you can imagine, these were much better results than I expected, and now I was hooked. I started asking myself, how fast can I make this thing before it fails? The answer was 1650 MHz. While the temperature seemed to be within the safe ranges for the CPU, any higher than that will crash any 3D application. On that insane frequency, Just Cause 2 went from 36 to 39, Bioshock went from 39 to 40, Skyrim pretty much stayed the same, and GTA 5 went from 36 to 38. So, not a lot of gain for something that could potentially be dangerous for the components and that had my CPU fan put in extra work. You will not believe how much noise this tiny fan was making. So it seems the jump to 1500 made the most difference. Maybe 1600 will make a nice sweet spot. I did not expect overclocking an integrated GPU to be a thing that was possible, let alone something that will provide such an interesting result. So the final question is, would I recommend this to someone gaming on Intel HD? The main problem with this procedure is obvious. It requires a motherboard that supports integrated GPU overclocking in order to achieve it. If you have a motherboard that supports it, I would definitely suggest it. If not, does it make sense to hunt down a new motherboard instead of saving for a dedicated GPU? Well, it depends. The H81MK I am using was already considered a budget motherboard when it released, and I have seen them sold used for as low as 25 euros, so if you manage to find out a card with GPU boosting features that work with your CPU for, say, 20 euros or dollars, it might work as a stepping stone if you're waiting up to get an expensive dedicated GPU. or just if, like me, you're interested in finding out if this was possible. Also, keep in mind, I did not tweak any of these games, so in all of these cases, there's more to be done to get more FPS. Just be aware that if you're running into a CPU problem, overclocking will not help that much. Thank you to everyone in Patreon who donates so I can buy stuff like this for experimental videos. Hope you found this interesting. I will see you on the next video.